Alright, what is going on, my social gamers? I'm Commander-in-Chief, Warzone 157, and welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. And I almost messed that title up. Now, the last time I was chatting with you guys, I was dealing with profiles. Now, let me see what this is. Soldier, it's pretty much just no human abilities, just have the ability to, you know, take more damage and have better accuracy. Engineer, I'm thinking it's more like dealing with tech. Now, do we come with any powers? Combat drone? That's it. Okay, what about Sentinel? Okay. Tech armor. I remember that from Mass Effect 2. Edit. Just biotic stuff. Infiltrator. Battlefield awareness. Observe enemies through walls using a scope. That's nice. Cloak evades. Oh, okay. You're an explorer. But wait, how would the game know when you are evading? That's what I don't understand. 3 points each invested in combat and tech skills. So I'm guessing that I can activate all of these. But I can only change it up for a certain time. Like, I can have one, but at the same time, I can keep getting points to unlock more. I don't know. This game doesn't do very well explaining what the hell is going on. I've kind of noticed that. And it's got a very convoluted setup as well. If you're trying to do something, unless you have photographic memory on what you did, it's kind of impossible. How do I even know if I have any points? Skill points. Is this the skill points? Or, no, that's dealing with the Nexus. That's dealing with the area that I'm in. So how would I actually know how many points that I have? Wait. So it wants me to... Huh? Okay. What the fuck? Invest in combat, tech, or biotic skills to unlock more powerful profiles in a variety of styles. Okay. If you say so. And what the hell is this on my shoulder? Alright, let me... And that's another thing. I wish this whole entire time, while I was editing stuff, I was trying to save my game. I understand I couldn't possibly do it at the first mission, which I still think is stupid, because you could have done that in the Pathfinder, Mass Effect 1.
Captain Dunn said to seal your father's cabin from anyone but you. It's open now.
Mass Effect 1, Mass Effect 2, and Mass Effect 3. It doesn't matter where you were. The game would still save itself, or you could have the opportunity to save it. This game doesn't let you do it at the beginning. Alright, let's take a look and see what my dad's got going on in this room.
Printed books.
Reproductions of Lewis and Clark's journals, detailing their expedition in the 19th century.
Explains dad's interest. They were pathfinders too.
Another thing. I changed the FOV if you guys haven't realized it. But it said multiplayer on the settings. Multiplayer FOV. Which I'm pretty sure it changed my FOV in this game. I might be wrong, I might be right. I don't know. All I do know about is that there's a nice Normandy SR2 ship right here. I'm gonna pick that up. And I'm assuming that these go to my ship when I get it, the Tempest, I think that's what it's called.
The coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you, needed the caffeine.
I did not realize I owed my existence to a bean.
And now you know what humility feels like.
Here's another thing. Oh, damn it, I just forgot about it. Oh, yeah, no, now I remember. The goddamn Omni-Tool. I don't like the new design. It just looks ugly to me. It looks like it's something that they were making in beta form, but they never finished it. I like the original Omnitool, because at least it looked like it was something.
Your father's first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Alec's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Crazy times.
Alright, sorry guys. Just had to make sure that everything was recording right, and I had the right microphone.
Sam? What was that?
An eidetic trigger, related to your father, and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Alec tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Samnod on the Hyperion to investigate further.
That's another thing, like... I'm not understanding this.
Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories which Alec wanted you to see.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Okay, something new every day.
I thought he was about to say violently. Okay, play the memory.
Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive, but an AI can.
How?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both. There's no creator to revolt against.
I'm sorry, Alec. We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied. Alec?
Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
Not on my watch.
Wow. Hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Alec was a stubborn man.
Seriously, on the right, what is going on with my guy's head / hair? It's like there's one dot, it's like a sideways U, and then the rest of it looks like hair. I'm sorry, but that's just really fucking distracting to me. It looks like I'm looking at a map on his fucking head. Alright, let me see. Mom's life was at stake. It was just his way. I'll say Mom.
I would hope so. Mom's life was worth fighting for.
It would seem his obstinance extended to me as well.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it. That's all for now.
Of course.
And what I'm trying to figure out is how in the hell would I know where to look for my father's memories? Would they be in the main story, or would I have to go to a side mission planet? This is all so confusing. I heard you can do that, like, weird... Eh. Come on. There we go. I don't know how they did it so well. Like that. But I finally got it to work. Now, I think Addison... Not Addison. See, this woman has no depth to her character, so I don't even remember who she is or what her name was. Here we go. If I'm ever going to remember her name, I'm just going to have to remember a good character in real life, Ryan Dunn. That's the only way I'm going to remember this bitch. Alright guys, give me 1 second. Let me get my my dog in, because she's just banging at that door like crazy.
Ryder.
You're not on the bridge, Captain?
We powered it down. Can't afford to waste energy. Though Cryo Bay and Sam Note are exempt. And I told them to keep their hands off Alex's quarters. You have access now.
Thanks.
Hey. Sorry about your father. He was really good at what he did. Just not so good at working with people. He was right about going planetside, though.
Wait, if he wasn't good with people, then how the fuck did he become an N7? You're supposed to relate to everybody, from humans to aliens to a lot of culture, so how is he not human-driven? Okay, I guess since I don't really know him. Or I kind of miss him, because he was one of the most interesting people there. Can't say he was difficult. We haven't worked with him that much. And only work mattered to him? I don't know. There wasn't really a backstory. Games like Gears of War 4 and this game don't really give you too much on what happened about these kids' past. Don't even give you the option like they did in Mass Effect. So you can build on his prologue. Or her prologue. Okay, I'll just go with sympathetic.
I wish you were still here. There's so much you could have taught me.
You'll do fine. You're off to a good start. If there's anything else I can help with, let me know.
So many jerks around these characters.
Thanks for the talk.
All right. I have requests to submit, administrators to harass, and people to wake up. I'd better get to it. Good luck out there.
Now, I haven't seen the big, big glitches that people have been showing on their channels. I hope I never get to that point. But I want to do one more thing before I reach the Tempest. We're going to go back to operations. Now, there was a point where I did actually go on the Tempest, and I tried to deal with my armor and my casual clothing to, like, figure out what kind of palette of colors I want to put on my stuff. I couldn't do it. It wouldn't save at all.
This Scourge. We know it is neither nebula.
Let's say what's going over here. Hey, Eric, come here.
You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Herrick. My colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
What fields do you study?
Herrick's into life sciences. I do planetary geology, oceanography, rocks and runoff. Aradana's the space and math whiz.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Look at this hair. Look at that. That's so freaking... Hold on, bitch, let me see your face. Not like you got a damn mustache. I swear, besides Korra, and that's by slightly, is the only good-looking female I see around here. By the way, I'm gonna let you guys... I think there's a reason why, and I just saw it. If you want to look at the, this dude on his channel, his name is The Act Man. I don't know if you guys have heard of him, but pretty much he talks about certain things about certain video games. I know I'm saying certain a lot, I do apologize. But he's a very cool guy. He talks a lot about Halo 5, Guardians, and all the stuff that we see as bullshit, and he sees it too, but he goes a little bit more in depth with it. He also talks about this game as well, and he hits the nail on every single head. Alright, now I'm trying to figure out where to go. I don't think I can talk to anybody else, or if they need any help. I already talked to Sweet Thighs. I already talked to her. I guess I can go and I tried talking to, what's her face? Sarah. But I don't think I have that option.
Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style.
Yo, what kind of fucking transition was that?
They call her the Tempest.
And I went back and I did see how Korra walked away when I was talking to Kesh. And I heard that there's someone else that does a weird walk too. But she's still doing it!
Let's go take a closer look.
What kind of face? What the fuck's going on with this face?
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra. Vetra Nix. Initiative Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything in between.
Are we ready? I'd like to know what's in between.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
Oh my god, did I actually fucking say that? Whew.
Yeah. Let's go see the rest of Helios.
Hold it, hold it. You're not going anywhere.
Oh, there we go.
Damn it.
I didn't do it, or is there a problem? I go, is there a problem?
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential. But I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Not if she doesn't know.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
And I take that was Korra speaking. I want to know why almost every single female has makeup on. And why their faces look like so fat. Look like damn Jagged Edge.
Everything's state of the art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Lesser crew, of course. The best in their field.
Ah, glad to see you looking well.
That's all you gotta say, Lexi, really?
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam.
And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
It's really gonna be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
It's just the faces, dude. The faces.
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
Special delivery cache. All right, there we go. And there we go. Oh, God. This is my hoodie? Looks like something a fucking social justice warrior would wear. Nah, fuck that. I'd rather look like a douche with a jacket. Fuck that shit. The fuck they think this is? Okay. Of course, I can't do it. See, and it doesn't show you... Select outfit. This is my outfit. Okay, casual outfit, armor customization. It just said that I had my stuff. If it's red, does that mean that it's a rare find or a legendary find? Or if that just means that I am not at a level that I can't wear it? And if that's so, then why do I need a level to access different armor? I understand I have to level up. But hell, even if I was a soldier, I would still have access to the heavy armor, no matter what. Or maybe not, I don't know. Alright, I'm gonna try and see if I can do something. Oh, fuck that, hoodie. I'm gonna try and see if I can customize my colors to the Warzone colors, alright? Okay, what the... Jesus. Okay, red for that. Black for that. And white for that. Okay. That's what I want, okay? Motherfucker! It's happening again. Am I doing something wrong? Like, seriously, am I doing something wrong to the point where I can't wear this stuff? Or do I need, some magical fucking level in order to get this thing? Let's try it again. Like, I don't know if I'm... Like, I'm pressing enter or F. Just anything that I can just have myself do. And it's like, the fuck? I'm not getting what I'm owed. They made this so fucking difficult. Okay, these are the colors I want to rock. Why can't I not rock the fucking colors? What button am I gonna have to fucking press? Because this is the outfit that I want. God damn it. Shit. Okay, let's go to short sleeve then. Let's see if I can do anything for this. Oh my god, really? Okay, seriously. Doc, these are the colors I want. I am clicking everything. I'm even trying to confirm this shit, okay? These are the colors I want. Am I very fucking clear? And nothing. Mother... Whoo! Okay, I'm gonna come back to it. But I'm telling you, this don't make no fucking sense. Do I even have an armory in my quarters? Okay, I got Sam, I got an email terminal. I got this fucking model. And special delivery area. And this don't do shit. So what exactly is going on with my wardrobe specifications? Why can't I access it? Alright, so I have to launch in order to get stuff done. Alright. Let's see what happens. Okay.
Departure trajectory locked, Nexus Control. Ah, time for introductions. You must be Ryder, Gallojath. A pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course. I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Helios.
Plenty of dangers out there, but I'll do my best to avoid them.
That's reassuring. Wouldn't want to lose my finest work to that angry cloud. I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
So how do I...
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here, and the nav system calculates everything. Very efficient.
It was optimized for a Pathfinder.
Everything's secure, if you're ready.
Is anyone ready for something this big?
We signed on for the big stuff when we came to Andromeda.
All right. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Command access is transferring successfully.
Science and monitoring stations look fine. Lexi's reporting in.
Helm is green. Gil reports the drive core is online.
This is it, Ryder. The Tempest is yours. Unless you've got something to say for the log.
Miss Suvi, please tell me you're not high and you're not driving this ship. Because you, from that look, from those eyes, you looked very high. Please don't crash us if you're driving. Keep dreaming of home. We're the Nexus' best hope. We got this. Huh. Let's do this. Keep everybody assured. Or reassure them.
We were all expecting a golden world. Now there's just a long road ahead. But hold on to that dream. It might see us through.
Nexus Control, this is the Tempest, ident 2527, prepping to depart.
Departure vector verified, Tempest. Godspeed, Pathfinder.
To Eos, then. What would have been our Habitat 1?
Two failed outposts put an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Callow, take us in.
Anomaly detected.
Alright, so I'm gonna go back here and I'm gonna go back to the Nexus. Cause if I can't get my weapons or my armor or even my colors for my casual clothing, at least the thing I can do is get my damn monkey. That's it. That's all I can hope for is getting my damn monkey. Can I please skip this? No, I can't. Alright, I looked everywhere, so this must be... Here we go.
Here we are. One young Pyjack. Ready to see Andromeda, huh? Sam, can you send a note to Kesh? Make sure our new friend gets delivered to the Tempest.
Acknowledged.
Alright, now we get to go back. But before I do, I'm gonna talk to this female real quick.
Ryder, isn't it? Kerry Tavessa, freelance vidmaker. This is Hakim, my producer. I could use your help.
What are you looking for?
Director Tanz asked for an uplifting documentary on the initiative. Translation, paint rainbows over our problems. But our problems are history. People deserve the truth, not propaganda.
Nice to see someone so devoted to her work.
That's kind. Sometimes the camera makes people shy away from me.
That's a shame.
So that's what I need. The truth, I mean. Someone needs to record the history we're making.
Truth might scare people, or that's very noble. I'll go with that's very noble.
It takes integrity to record the truth and nothing but.
Well, I do my best. And you could help me out. The heart of my documentary will be an interview series. I was hoping you'd take part. I want the dirt and blood of our story, not the convenient fairy tale Tan's looking for. Interested?
You don't mind treading on the initiative director's toes?
What would he do? Pull funding we don't have? I'm game if you are.
Okay, interview away.
Let's start at home. 14 months and the Nexus still isn't finished. Arcs are missing, we have people in exile. By any standard, this wasn't the plan. Our leadership describes these as anticipated issues. Would you agree?
For pioneers, they are. No, we need to do better. I don't know which one to choose, actually. For pioneers, they are. No, we need to do better.
We still have to fix them. Everyone, leaders included, needs to pitch in. Let's be honest about these challenges and how we're going to face them.
Nice. Won't make you popular with the leaders, but it's good to hear. Bandwidth means I'm transmitting in short bursts, so that's all for now. But you can bet I'll have more questions later. This was more fun than I expected. You were great. I'll get to work editing.
And she goes running off. Oh, I hear him. Okay, buddy, where are you? Okay, he's not in there. He's not in here. Where is my monkey? Okay, I'm going up here. Come on, get up, get up, get up. God dang, all this for a damn monkey. All of this. Okay, he's not.
We haven't really spoken since orientation, have we?
It's all been so hectic.
Here we go.
Oops. Looks like our pijack friend got out of his cage. He'll be fine. Won't he? The exercise will probably do him good.
Wait a minute, hold on. I can't. That was
nice
petting?
Place you found.
Clean air, plants. Helps me think.
Something on your mind?
Maybe.
Your biotics always do that when you're maybe stressed?
I got it. I'm good. I don't normally lose it like that. A huntress should have better control.
Huntress?
Another term for an Asari commando. I was one before the initiative. Some things stick, though. Like losing the old man.
How does a human soldier get to serve with Asari?
Prove your biotics can rip an APC apart, and people get nervous. Funny that. The Alliance found me a cross-species military initiative in a hurry. Sent me to Thessia to serve with a Huntress unit. One of the few places where my powers were welcomed. Your father made another one.
There's a lot of loss going around. Dad, the Golden Worlds.
A friend and mentor who trained you to be a Pathfinder. I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he chooses you? An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
Is this going to be a problem, Cora?
I don't want a rival. Just answers. It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then maybe we'll all get what we came out here for.
Do I want to do this? Do I want to? I'll just do it for once.
You, me, side by side? I like the sound of that.
Don't be charming when I'm mad at you.
Are you? You're not glowing. Blushing, maybe.
Look, there's still the mission. A lot of dreams to fulfill.
Even if we get there, there's a mountain of hard work ahead.
Working hard was never my problem. Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was meant to be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through. It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark. If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise. If you want to talk, I'll be here.
Okay, I'm getting a little bit off topic and off track. So what I'm going to do on stop video here, and if need be, give 2 quick pass in a hurry. When we come back, we'll, I guess, head to Eos. So I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you soldiers in the next battle log.